One more time, give thanks to God for all that He's done. Let's go ahead and thank Him. Let's consciously tell God, thank you for every miracle, every sign, every wonder. Let's tell God, thank you. Open your mouth and tell God, thank you. Blessed be God forever. In Jesus' mighty name. In Psalm 106, verse 4, the Bible declares, Psalm 106, verse 4, remember me, O Lord, with the favor that thou bearest unto thy people. Oh, visit me with thy salvation. The Lord will remember you with good things today. He said, remember me, O Lord. If God remembers you, story must change. The day God remembered Joseph was the day his prison life ended. I don't care how long you have suffered. God will remember you for good today. He said, God remembered Sarah, a captivity turned. God can't remember you and your life remain the same. Now I decree in the name of Jesus, you'll be remembered for good. I'm speaking directly to someone. God will remember you for good. Not tomorrow, today. Say to me, God will remember me for good. If you know you are the one, say it one more time. Now, today shall be to a day where God will remember you. Something good will happen to you. Evil will stop in your life. In the precious name of Jesus. Because you have opened your mouth to say so, it will be so. Father, speak to us in this service. Let your word come fresh, empowered and encapsulated by the Holy Ghost to bring forth the results of our lives. In Jesus' mighty name. Give me a big hand. You may be seated. Glory to God. Today is a special anointing service. Two of the three Sundays today, next Sunday and the upper Sunday, will be anointing services. Next Sunday is supernatural favor, anointing also. The same oil, but that will be for favor. Is that clear? I'll take a short charge and then I'll share the message with you in this special anointing service. Failure and success is a choice. You can choose to succeed and you can also choose to fail. God speaking said, I lay before you life and dead, choose life. Blessing and cursing. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 19. Life is choice. You choose what you want to become. And the most complicated thing in life is choice. You can be seated now and decide to switch off and say, I choose not to hear Papa. But you are seated. You know it's possible. Anything wants to talk, let him talk. Just switch off. Life is a what? It's a choice. But nobody fails or succeeds by accident. There are principles that lead to success, and there are also principles that lead to failure. Just obey the law of not studying, you will fail in school. Just be diligent, you succeed in business. Are you getting me? Life is a product of what? Choices. Now, one of the choices you must make now in life is to plan. Is it what? It's to plan. A wise man said, if you fail to plan, you are planned to fail. Planning is a written list of arranged actions necessary to achieve your desired goal. It is creating a mental picture of your expectation. Many of us, we go into action when we have no plan. To be successful, you have to plan. No man arrives at the mountaintop accidentally. If you don't have a plan, then you don't have a future. At the planning stage of your future, you have to think, you have to ponder on how to realize your dreams and goals. In Proverbs chapter 24, 3 and 4, the TLB translation, it says, any enterprise is built by wise planning, becomes strong through common sense, and profits wonderfully by keeping abreast of the fast. 24, verse 4. Verse 4. Are you giving me verse 5? And profits wonderfully by keeping abreast of the fast. Glory to God. He said, which of you intending to build a tower? Proverbs, sorry, Luke 14, 28. He said, which of you intending to build a tower? Send another friend, I can't, because if you'll be able to finish it. Subject to finish it. If I have to succeed, then I must plan. I must do what? You know what I'm saying? So the year is coming to an end. Many have no plan for next year. Have no plan for their lives. Have no plan for the future. Because when you plan, you will eliminate stress. It will terminate frustration. It will grant you progress. May that be your testimony. Anywhere you see stress, it's an indication that someone is not planning. Anywhere you see yourself running, blue, 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 you are not what? With planning, you find that you are not under pressure. Every day I'm under pressure, you lack planning. You lack what? Planning. The prodigal son walked out of hardship through planning. In Luke 15, 17 to 18. I will look at tips for effective planning. Tips for effective planning. In the first sermon, I said, have a great picture of the future. Have a great picture of the future. Second sermon, I said, number two, go for relevant information. In this third service, number three, write down your plan for the future. Write down your what? How many of you have plans? Let me see your hand up. Everybody has plan? You now know you don't have any plan. When I'm through with you, you will see from Bible that you don't have plan. Nobody will mark you. Only you mark yourself. How about cook 2-2? Habakkuk 2:2. Okay, let's write together. Let's read together. I want to go. And the Lord answered me and said, what did he say? Stop. Write the plan. How many of you wrote down something you want to do? You find that 99% do not write down. Don't deceive yourself. Don't tell lies even in church. You didn't write down. Studies are sure that only 3% of people write down what they want to do for the next few years. 97% of people don't write. You didn't write it down. Don't deceive yourself. Okay, where did you write it down? You didn't write. Don't deceive yourself. That would be self-deception. 97% of people don't write down what they want to do. They just say, well, next year I'll build a house. Next year I'll try and go read 4 books. That's no plan. Any plan not written down is a wish, not a plan. Say, I wish to do. Not say, I plan to do. Plan means it must be documented. It must be what? Documented. God said, write the vision and make it plain upon tables. Tables means something like tablet, book, diary, that he may run that he did it. So that when you say you, and each plan must have time, must have what? Any plan not written is not a plan. Write down in details what you want to accomplish. Your plan must contain a detailed information of the step-by-step process. Make a list of things to do every day of your life. I do something, that's why I can sit in one place and achieve so much. Now listen, as a lifestyle, don't get up any day without writing down what you want to do the previous day. Write down everything. Delegate a specific assignment to each hour. That way you will never waste time. 6 to 7, morning prayers. 7 to 8, I read this book. This to this, I do my work in the office. This to this, I go to church. Write it down. Phone calls, this to this. That way your life will be so organized. Somebody can't stumble into you and just turn you off. Your plan should be futuristic. Write it down. Now let me ask you a very sincere question. December has come through. Next year is a new year. You are planning for one day. You are planning for what? Christmas, which is not bad. It's a celebration of Jesus. But you have not planned for the whole year coming next year. People plan for wedding. They don't plan for marriage. People plan for Christmas. They don't plan their lives. They are planning for the event. They don't plan the relationship with the man we are celebrating. People plan their lives, don't plan for heaven. Are you getting what I'm talking about? You are going to pay school fees in January. You are going to pay rent in January. But you're busy buying clothes. You're busy spending money. And when your landlord comes January, you say, I bind him. I want to stand here to say, I lose your landlord. He didn't build his house for you not to pay. He said, oh, this principal is too wicked. No. Even the people who come to church to worship God. Please, everyone comes to church, come to worship God. Stop warning people who come to church. Stop giving note to people. They didn't come because of you. Plan your life. Too often. I've never begged any mortal man because I planned my life. Whatever I don't have, I don't stress myself to get it. So I hear. Are you hearing me? Live your life by planning. By what? By planning. Because you must pay school fees. No, don't use faith. It can't take the place of planning. And don't use prayer. It's never a substitute for planning. Your children must pay school fees. Now you are going to go to the village. Before you go to a village, balance it. I'm going to spend this amount for my journey. I'm going to spend this amount. School fees must come first. Your rent must come, true? Before you buy a car. Because you must live in a house. Car, you can have transport. But you can't have a rented, you can't transport house. Even if you use caravan, people will ask you, are you okay? Plan. Anywhere you see pressure, planning is not involved. Every pressure shows there's no what? Planning. I've never borrowed. You know why? Plan. If I don't plan, I'll borrow. It's very simple. It's very what? I've not been under the financial pressure because of planning. I buy what I can buy. What I don't have, I don't buy. I don't put myself under what? I'm not here to please people and displease myself. Please, December is coming. I'm saying this because that is the problem of Christians. No planning. Know what? I believe God. It's stupidity. Don't believe God for what you plan. He gave you brain so you can give him rest to gain in your life. He said, come, let us reason so you can stop disturbing God. Some prayer points are stupid. If you reason, why are you praying for school fees when you can carry your children to a school that you can afford? Why you pray for house rent when you can live in a house you can afford? You're living in a 3-bedroom flat. Then you want to flatten your life. Go back to 1-bedroom flat you can afford. When God bless you, go back to 3 bedrooms. Why you live in a house? You want everybody. I believe God. I believe God. I believe God. You don't believe God, they pay. They don't believe God. You are sending your children overseas to go to schools where you can only afford 1 year school fees. Forget that the many years you have to pay. So the child, he will walk. Who told you? There's no work you will do overseas that can pay school fees. You can only work to pay bills. So the children go out of school after 1 year. He said, this is my child, he's not into drugs. Why would the child not go to drugs when the child is depressed? Plan your life. Let them go to school in Nigeria. When they graduate, your country, when they graduate, if you have money, they now go for masters. If you don't have money, they stay. And most of you who are today successful, you didn't go to school abroad. True? My friend's children are in Canada. All my friends, they are what? Before you count your own children. You do have the money for what? If you don't have the money for Canada, you can better go to Canada. Better go to where? Look at the map. If you You know, we are not in a competition. I'm not competing with any. I told them yesterday. I said the flight we entered was an all-economic flight. If it's a food, they will not enter. They said, no, Papa, I enter economy. Does it remove anything from my body? I'm still Papa. I enter economy. It doesn't remove anything. Life is not. Look, this life. It's economy I enter. Going and coming, you know, they don't have any business class. The whole plane, I can buy it. But that was what happened. But if someone, no. I enter economy for what? Who know you? Who know you? You pass, nobody even greet you. You are not even a threat to anybody. Calm down. Plan your life. Do what? Don't put yourself under pressure. If you borrow from any, in this church you borrow, this December, to buy clothes, I pray that they just wait for you in front of the church. They remove your wig, remove your shirt. The wig where you borrow, when they call, they just pull it off. The shoe, they say, remove and pull more your shoe. Then you're going to walk out with barefoot. Like all this. If I be the people where you borrow from, I will come to church, I will wait for you. When you come, I say, madam, you don't pay me. The shoe again is, you don't pay me. Pull your shoe. Then you go take a leg, they walk out like all this people where they go, all those kind of places. Calm down. Where the one you go feed? Where? Why are you killing yourself? Who is competing with you? Who won't look yourself? Stay there. It's not bad to celebrate Christmas, but wisdom demands your plan. This is the beginning of the month. Plan. Some of you will not even pay tithe. Then when you come back, you say, Father. And people who don't pay tithe, they pray too much. Father, they never did this. All these demons warning people, holding my money, I bind you. God said, bind yourself. Shout hallelujah. But I'm sure you'll plan your life. Rise to your feet. Let's take a worship. Lift your right hand and say, Father, I'll plan my life. I receive grace to live well according to my size. In Jesus' name. Amen. Let's worship and then we'll go to the anointing section. The anointing section be exceptional. Jesus' mighty name. You may be seated. Thus word declares in Genesis chapter 1, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. The earth was without form and void. It means it was chaotic. It was shapeless, it was formless, no beauty to behold. And darkness was upon the face of the deep. And then the Holy Ghost moved upon the face of the waters. And God declared, let there be light. This anointing section, everywhere darkness has stood against your destiny, the power of the Holy Spirit moved that darkness away. It's not by might. It is not by power, but by my Spirit, saith the Lord. The Holy Ghost, give me illustration. Is there anybody? Give me a cloth, like cloth. Let me demonstrate what God was showing to me. Just cloth, just bring cloth. I want somebody to come who is going through hardship. Somebody going through some hard times, one person come. Just come. This is what stand. Please touch the key. No, face this way. This is what the devil does over people. It covers you like this. This man, there's no good thing that can behold him. You can't see him. If this man wants to go for business, his eyes are closed. Nobody can know who he is. Darkness has covered him. That's how so many of your life, your destiny, everything about you just covered darkness. And then the power of the Holy Ghost. This is what the Holy Ghost does. Just what this man, he can't be able to stand. This is what the Holy Ghost does. It just goes like this. I don't understand what I'm talking about. Everywhere darkness has beclouded your destiny, I command that darkness, roll away in the name of Jesus. Every darkness sat on your life, the power of the Holy Ghost. Darkness covered your house. You couldn't complete that house. Satan sat on the building. I went to a man's house for 9 years. He couldn't pass DBC. That man, we anointed the house and he filled the house in less than 3 months. I don't know what darkness sat on your destiny and business and career. I command you, roll away in the name of Jesus. I command that darkness out now in the name of Jesus. I speak God's glory over your life and destiny. Somebody who says amen, you have it done. Somebody who says amen, you have it done. In the name of Jesus. Now it shall come to pass in that day that the burden shall be lifted off your shoulder and the yoke from off their neck, and the yoke shall be dissolved because of the anointing. Isaiah 10:27. Every yoke over your life is destroyed now. He said, I shall go before you and make the crooked place straight. Isaiah 45. And I break in pity against the records under the bars of iron. Every gate of brass shut on your destiny, be opened in the name of Jesus. He said, thus saith the Lord to his anointed, to serve Israel and ever holy, to subdue nations before him. Nations that do not never answer to you, they will be subdued right now. And I'll give the hidden treasures. The blessings belonging to you and I that were hidden, I command the release in the name of Jesus. That's Isaiah 45:1-3. He said, the righteous shall fall like a palm tree. Those that have been planted in the house of the Lord, they shall still bring forth fruit in old age. I decree from this day, you will flourish and continue to prosper. Till your time on earth is over, you will never beg to eat. If you believe it, say amen like a believer. And I'm not ignorant, because every time a man flourishes, people are angry. He says, you shall see your desire upon your enemies. Those who say, oh, why is this man progressing? Why is this lady progressing? I decree them to go blind.
those that want to attack you, assassinate you, or plan evil against you, they will go down this week. Ever planning our downfall, I command them to fall now. If you believe the word of God, let your amen be the loudest. He said, that was Psalm 92, 12 to 14, we have read, and 10 and 11. He brought me up also out of an horrible pit, Psalm 40, verse 2. Now, no matter the pit you have been in, I command you to come out. Jesus spoke to Lazarus in the pit, and Lazarus came out. They didn't use hand. Any pit you have been in, pit of sickness, pit of poverty, pit of shame, pit of regrets, every pit you have been in, come out in the name of Jesus. God will set your feet in high places. If you are the one who is bouncing back again, rise and say amen. Meditating for this service, deep meditation, the Holy Ghost gave me this scripture last night. He said, now, not tomorrow, 2 Corinthians 3:17, now the Lord is that spirit. And where the spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. Don't just quote it. Now is our spirit. Deliverance means there is freedom. Freedom from every addiction. Even freedom. There are people into drugs. They can't be free. They take today, they go back. They go back again. They go back again. Now, everything that kept you bound, you are free from them in the name of Jesus. In case they took your name to a shrine, I command your liberty now. Satan, take your hands off God's precious people. By the power of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Take your hands off. Say with me, Satan. By the power of the Holy Ghost. Take your hands off my life. Off my career. Off my children. Open your mouth. By the power of the Holy Ghost. Satan, take your hands off my destiny. My life. My business. My career. Open your mouth and say, take your hands off. By the power of the Holy Ghost. Take your hands off. Of my destiny. Of my family, says so. Of this church. Open your mouth. Get out, Satan. Take your hands off my marriage, say that out, off my body, off my career, off my business. Say something in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. So when the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Holy Ghost shall lift up a standard against him. Wherever someone's attacking your force, the Holy Ghost will lift a standard against him. First Samuel, that's Isaiah 59:19b. First Samuel 16, verse 13, he said the Holy Ghost came upon David when the day was anointed. The Holy Ghost come upon that oil right now. Yes, it ceases to be an ordinary oil. Yes, in the name of Jesus. After Saul was anointed, the Bible declares in First Samuel 10, he said, you shall make him a captain out of the heritage. Wherever you have been a captive, return as a captain. Yes. Then he went further to say, today when that's departed from me, they asked me that I wanted to seek, I found. Whatever you have lost, it will be recovered today. I'm speaking to someone, you will recover today. Maybe property belonging to you, you believe you can never get back. I decree. Something you lost for years will be restored. I decree today to be a day of restoration. In case they sack you, you are going to be called back again in the name of Jesus. He said, then shalt thou go on forward. From this day, make progress. I'm reading 1 Samuel chapter 10, beginning from 1. I said, make progress. Stagnation is over with you. He said, they will give you two loaves. Out of three, they gave you two loaves. From today, your name shall be called Alliance Favor. In the name of Jesus. They will salute thee. From this day, people will get up to greet you. They will not grieve you, they will greet you. the honor that was removed will be restored. If you believe it, say amen like a believer. Somebody's dignity is restored. The louder your amen, you have it. You say, and the Spirit of the Lord come and that shall prophesy with them. From today, you'll be turned to another personality. He said, do as occasion serve you. I decree people that do not know you will begin to look for you. He says, Saul also among the prophets, after this day, they'll call your name among those who are wisdom. It will be said, is this lady among those who are getting married? Is this brother among those who are getting married? Is this woman among those who are dedicating children? Something good, your name will be identified with it. But here they said, hear me well, it's as they went from one nation to another, from one kingdom, that they allowed no man to do them wrong. It brings me, as they say, touch not my anointed. As you are blessed today, you are touched not to evil. If that is you, amen, confirms it. He said, I found David my servant, with my holy oil have I anointed him, with whom my hand shall be established. I'm reading Psalm 89, 20 to 23. He said, the enemy shall not exert upon none, so wickedness afflict him. I will beat down his foe before his face and plague them that hate him. Now hear me. Whoever says I hate you will be plagued now. Someone spoke derogatory against me. If he never came to my wife, I won't know. When he spoke so badly, everything about him closed, including his wife, she left him. He couldn't pay rent. He came to my wife and said, I spoke against Papa. I was in this church, but as I left, I spoke against him and everything about my life closed. And I was praying and God told me to go back to him. That you left another church does not mean you're free. You are not the one who called me. It's God who called. You can't judge me. You can't judge me. Tell me where you give me appointment later. He called me. He's the only one who's right over anointed men. That's why you must not talk about anointed men. Allow God. Their own employment. Everyone employed, they give you later. They give appointment later. Including the political politics. Don't they give you later? Tell us who gave us later. There's nobody, whether governor, deputy governor, senator, they gave you paper. True? Okay, who gave us paper? No paper. So be careful of us. We don't have appointment later. It's only he who has power over us. So when you want to talk about us, you can advise us, but don't judge us. You can what? But don't judge us. We are not your miss. Our appointment letter is from God. The man close. But you to a child of God, true? Whoever says I hate you will suffer plague now. Now listen. In 24 hours, all those who hate you will suffer devastation. Everyone that says I hate you will be plagued before 6 p.m. Anyone who has carried your name to any evil shrine, thunder will strike now in the name of Jesus. Anyone who has carried your children's name to evil shrine, thunder will strike now. Any armed robber planning to attack us, as I said, we die. If you believe in same like a believer. God has brought you to your own wealthy place. And before I run off, there shall be supernatural miracle conceptions. He said, and the Holy Ghost came upon her, Mary. Luke 1:35. Now I command the power of the Holy Ghost to rest on anyone in the name of Jesus. Every negative medical verdict is canceled. And I decree the power of the Holy Ghost to make this happen. Young men and women will get married. There will be open doors for appointments of all kinds. They will employ you where you never submitted later. And above all, you'll be exempted from hardship. If you read the book of Exodus,
8, 9, you see everything I want to share with you at Genesis. And I hear this for time's sake. There was no progress for the Egyptians in Exodus 8, 22. No swarm of flies were there, but Israel was free in verse Exodus 8, 22. Now hear this. Swarm of flies implies stench and decadence. Whatever is making people smell in other nations, you will not be part of it. There was economic recession in Exodus 9, 3 to 6. But the children of Israel, their business never failed. Nobody to my voice, your business will fail again. Please, just don't do things that will make them fail. Do your own part. But I tell you, no economy can make your business to fail. There was tragic occurrence. He said, there shall not evil before the end place come near their dwell. But only the land of Goshen, Exodus 9 to the 6, there was no hail. Hail means flood, losses, destruction of properties. Life story in Houston, Texas. Some years back, there was the biggest flood that happened in Houston where people died in covered houses. A cousin of mine called me and said, sir, the water is coming. And we just spoke. It was part of a service like this. The water got to his front and went back. Houston was closed. It has never happened. Even an hotel manager, she didn't know, press lift, died inside the lift. The lift took her down. Water has covered the lift. So she didn't know when she went down. Couldn't come up again. It killed people. Bridges over, light over, flyover bridges were closed with water. But yet, it didn't go near anybody connected to this church. Even when water moved towards their houses, it stopped. I decree to everyone connected to my voice, evil will never come near your house. Finally, for time's sake, the hardship in the land will not affect you. How do I know? Genesis 47, 15 and 27. And when money failed. When what? So money, the valuation of money is not new. In the land of where? In the land of Canaan. All the Egyptians came unto Joseph and said, give us bread, for why should we die in thy presence, for the money failed. So money is not a new thing. But look at verse 27. See the paradox. And Israel dwell in the land of what? The same place? In the country of where? That's where you'll be blessed. They'll call your place country. They call Canaan land country. Redemption camp country. Inside Nigeria. Because Canaan land, no power failure. Redemption camp, no power failure. They're in a different country. They're in Nigeria, but not in Nigeria. Oh my God. And they had possessions therein and grew. The same children of Israel. Has God changed? If you don't believe, God will not do it. Me, I believe. Say, I believe. Now, what is happening to other people in the nation where you are will not happen to you. I said, what is happening to other people will not happen to you. The economic crisis in the nation. Now, it is what you believe. Oh. You know, people are funny. They say, Papa, I don't know. You don't know what to talk. Listen, the moment you do that, you stop the miraculous. I warn you now, by the lead of the Holy Ghost, a man of God called Elisha in 2 Kings chapter 7, God will say, by this time tomorrow, this is what will happen. Then one man said, forget this, I read economics. By my economics, that can happen. See what they took at it here. And then a Lord on whose hand the king leaned answered the man of God and said, behold, if the Lord, read verse 1 first. So they can't understand. And then Elisha said, this is Elisha speaking. Hear ye the word of the Lord, just where I'm speaking. Thus says the Lord, tomorrow, Elisha was saying, by tomorrow, there was famine in the land. He said, by tomorrow, about this time, shall a meal of fine flour be sold for a shekel. He said, by, just like Elijah, he said, by tomorrow, naira will be equal to dollar. You know, people will say like this. I didn't say that's what will happen. No. I'm just saying, assuming God gave you such a word. You know, people will say, yeah, this man is crazy. I can't die. By all and they'll begin to listen. That was what happened here. Please don't misquote me. I never said naira will be one equal to this. So if you write against me, you are dead. I never said so because people are useful misinterpreted. I never said naira will be equal to dollar. I didn't say so. I said, assuming you say such a thing, people will not believe it because they will say, what I cannot. Now, Elisha said, by this time, tomorrow. So the man said, He said, and the Lord on whose hand the king lay, that's the economic advisor, answered the man of God. And said, behold, if the Lord would make windows in heaven, might these things be. Elisha was angry. And he said, behold, thou shalt see with thy eyes, but thou shalt not eat thereof. You know what happened? It happened. They matched the man, they trampled the man dead. For doubting. In every church, some people are funny. This thing Baba is talking, you know, it doesn't go out. It's just on the altar. It doesn't even go to forex exchange market. What does he know? He's saying, me, from Ogubolo. Ogubolo man. Hey, say by this time, I will have money. It's a lie, yo. If he knows what's happening in Bolo, he will not be talking like that. He's smart making plim, because he stays in Port Harcourt, doesn't go to Bolo, doesn't go to Bite. No, Wachara, doesn't go there. Where does he go? He doesn't go to Jebu. All he knows is just there. My friend, calm down. To as many as believe, I decree you will be exempted. You will not suffer what others are suffering. Hey! There's power in what you believe. How many of you believe? Now, to those who believe, your story has changed. In the name of Jesus, this month shall be your best month. You will end this year as your best year. In the name of Jesus, you are going to pray. Take the oil and a little in your hand and say, pray that by reason of today's anointing, the doors of breakthroughs, favor, lift his exit and be open unto you. He that opened and no man shut it. He said, every time I'm reading Revelation 3:7. He said, by this of today's anointing, the doors will what? Open. Breakthrough doors, favor doors, lifting doors. And anything that you want to say, take the oil in your hand. As in the name of Jesus, every word declared must come to pass in my life right now. All the doors that were shut, they will be open. And every word spoken must come to pass in my life. Anoint yourself and pray for yourself in the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. Open your mouth and declare so in the name of Jesus right now. In Jesus' mighty name, I got a clear word. I didn't get it in the first and second services. When you get home, when you get what? Anoint your gates and your doors. If it's not your compound, don't anoint it though. You're not the owner. Hey, I'm saying now. If you're coming back, I just got the word. Just anoint. I say, I command the doors of exploits open to this family. All churches, splash your gates. They're after this service. Well, I'm led by the Spirit of God. All our churches, go anoint the gates, anoint the entrances. Under this service, I'm beginning to command it to happen so. If you are the owner of the place, then you do it. Hey, I'm saying now. Don't go to another man's house and be the man who thinks that you're a witch doctor. But if you are the owner of the house, splash some oil. Hey, I'm saying now. Be open now to everything. Are you understand? Churches command be open for exploits and every darkness leave. Speak over that place. That is where great anoint your door, anoint your office. When they say anoint, it's very simple. Just put the oil on your head. When you enter your office, you just put your finger on the door. That's all. Don't go and stand there between like this. You think that you're a witch doctor. Just this is a public office. You just touch the door and say, this office, because of my sake, exploits. And you enter. Are you understand now? The day you leave, the express stop. That's anoint the office. That's wisdom. Don't go, but don't go and stand in another man's office and say, I'm not. He said, come. Wait, what are you doing here? Are you the owner of his office? But they think a witch doctor. But God spoke to me. And when he speaks to me, there's a reason. Anoint your doors, anoint your gates. As you're entering, as you're what? It's a command. No darkness crosses this place. Express to this place in Jesus' name. Now, if you're not born again, give your life to Jesus wherever you are. by praying this prayer after me. Don't sit down. I say, give your life. You are sitting down. Pray this prayer after me. Those of you who are not born again, say, Lord Jesus, I come to you. I accept you as my Lord and Savior. I believe in my heart that you died and rose from there to save me. Thank you, Father, for saving me. In Jesus' mighty name. If you offer that prayers, keep standing. All others take their seats.